Hi everyone, this is Grace. How are you? You know, we would live up to age 100 and we might be working until age 80. You know why? If you retire around age 60 or 65, and if we were to live up to age 100, then would you have enough savings or would you have multiple streams of income to cover your 35 to 40 year living expense? Not only living expense, but when you age, most of your expense will be medical bills and hospital bills. So please, let's redesign your life. And while you can, you should start doing second business, side projects, and investments, so that by the time you reach age 60 or 65, you would have some sort of income streams. And also, I want you to change your life, change yourself. I know it is difficult because we are a creature of habits, and it's almost impossible to change your habits overnight. So I am making this 30-day series of videos that every day, just a little baby step, I am suggesting you to make change per day. And hopefully at the end of 30 days, you would be amazed. You would be happy about the change you have made. So today is day 7. I am suggesting you just to try. Put all of your banks up. Expose your forehead. You know why? In face reading, we say forehead is what shows your intellectual level. The forehead would tell you whether or not you are a smart person. And in order for you to earn or reach for abundance, you need to be smart. There are two ways to be smart: the book smart and the street smart. The book smart is how well you can study your school, academia. But even though you are straight A students, you may not become millionaire, because you know what? You need to be street smart as well. So I would say it's 50-50, or it might be even 49%, 51%. 51% more important to be street smart than just a book smart, or you know how to take a test, the score high, okay? So back to this face reading. One of the face readings, we would look for forehead, because forehead would show how smart you are. Could be book smart or could be street smart. So either way, it's just your smartness is your forehead. So don't have heavy banks. In heavy banks, don't hide your forehead completely. Just show your forehead. If you can show everything, that's good. Or at least show a little bit, like me, maybe two-thirds of your forehead should be exposed, so that it would tell people impression that you are a smart person or you are intellectual person. You know, don't hide your forehead with heavy, heavy bangs. That would make you look dumb. You don't want people think you are dumb, you know, or immature or childish. And, you know, you tend to attract the people with the like mind. So if you like to meet spouse, if you like to marry to somebody who is smart, then you have to look smart too. So today, day 7, just put your bangs up, or just, you know, groom your hair so that people can see good portion of your forehead. Okay, that's all for today. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.